Hi class, today we're going to take a look at scientific notation, and we're going to take a look at some very small numbers and very large numbers in order to see what scientific notation is all about, because really all scientific notation does is give you another way to write really large and really small numbers so that it doesn't take as much room to basically write those. Scientists often deal with very small and very large numbers, and that is why this notation is important for them. And really the notation uses the fact that multiplying by 10 moves your decimal over to make an item larger, and dividing by 10 moves your decimal over to make a number smaller, and it just uses that little fact in order to rewrite items. Now let's take a look at a very large number and see how you might deal with it in scientific notation. Let's say that you had 7800000000, which is a very large number, and when you're writing it over and over and over again, if you accidentally miss one of those zeros or accidentally add another zero on, it would be something that might be a fairly significant mistake if you're talking about, say, a budget of the country or the number of molecules that exist. So it's important to be very accurate with this. And if you use scientific notation, you don't have to worry about whether you have the right number of zeros or not. So what scientific notation does is it takes a look at where your decimal is. And right now my decimal is here on the end. And it says, okay, let's move that decimal. We're going to move it, in this case, since it's a large number, this direction, and place it in a strategic location that makes this number easier to deal with. In fact, we're going to place it so there's only one non-zero digit to the left of it, which would put it right here between the 7 and the 8, because that would make a 7 to the left of the decimal, and 7's a non-zero digit. So that's going to be 7.8, but 7.8 is not the same number as what we see right here. So we need to record how far we moved that decimal in order to make it so this number is the same as this number. And we do that by multiplying by 10 to an exponent. And to figure out what exponent we need right here, what we do is we count how many decimal places we moved the decimal over. So let's do that. We moved it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 places. And since this was a very large number, we're going to use a positive 9 for our exponent. Very large numbers have a positive 9, and very small numbers have a negative 9. Because to get from the 7.8 back to here, you would have to multiply by 10. In fact, you would have to multiply by 10 9 times in order to get from here back to, from this 7.8 back to this number here. And since you're multiplying by 10 9 times, we have a positive 9 right here. Now let's take a look at a very small number. What if we have 0.0000000065? That was our number. Notice our decimal right now is right here. And this very, very small number, if we left out a zero or we added a zero in, would change significantly. So we want to rewrite it in scientific notation so we can keep track of how many zeros we have here. And to do that, we need to move this decimal here somewhere so that it has one non-zero digit to the left. And if you go across here, the first non-zero digit is a 6. So if we move the decimal so that 6 is to the left of it, it'll be between the 6 and the 5 here. So that gives us 6.5. But we need to record how far we moved it so that we don't change our number, because 6.5 is not the same as this original number. So to record how far we moved it, we multiply by 10 to an exponent. And that exponent records how far we moved our decimal. And since we're moving it this direction, because this is a very small number, this exponent's going to be negative, and I'll show you why in just a minute. So let's look at how far we moved our decimal. We moved it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 places to get it right here. So we're going to use a negative 8 for our exponent. Now the reason why it's a negative is because this 6.5 right here, if you wanted to get it back to this number right here, you would have to take the 6.5 and divide it by 10 8 times to get from 6.5 back to here. And when you divide by 10, that's really 10 to the negative 1 being multiplied by it. So if you're dividing by 10 8 times, that's equivalent to a 10 to the negative 8. And that's why we write this number like this in order to get it in scientific notation. Now, let's take a look at some situations that make it so we have to take these scientific notation type numbers, or numbers written in scientific notation, and use some operations with them. So, for instance, let's say we have a couple of numbers that represent something special. For instance, let's say that we have 2.5 times 10 to the 8. And maybe that represents how many molecules you have in a petri dish or something like that. And let's say that you weigh one little molecule, and the weight of that one little molecule happens to be 5 times 10 to the negative 3 milligrams. And you want to know how much does all of the molecules weigh. So in order to do that, you would take the weight of one of them and multiply it by how many you have. So in essence, we're taking 2.5 times 10 to the 8 and multiplying it by 5 times 10 to the negative 3. Now, to do this problem, you would do it very similar to how you would do 2.5 x to the 8th times 5 x to the negative 3. If you did this, you would multiply the 2.5 times the 5, and when you do that, you get 12.5. And then you would multiply your x's, x to the 8th times x to the 3rd is x to the 5th, then you'd get x to the 5th. Now, what we did here is going to be the same thing we do here, except for instead of an x in our problem, we have a base of a 10. So we're going to leave it as a base of a 10. And what's going to happen is we end up doing 2.5 times 5, which is 12.5. And then 10 to the 8th times 10 to the negative 3, you add the exponents, and you get 10 to the 5th. And in scientific notation, we do tend to use the x for our multiplication, but I really actually would strongly urge you in all other cases to use a parenthesis or a dot for multiplication, because we have variables in our problems and it's easy to get confused. So we don't really want to use that for multiplication unless we're in scientific notation. So now, you've got this answer, and you think, wow, I got the answer. I'm going to write it down, and it's correct. But we started out in scientific notation. We need to end in scientific notation. And if you look at this 12.5 here, I have two digits to the left of my decimal. I only want one digit to the left. So I need to move this digit right here. And if I move that digit right there, what's going to happen is I'm going to have to move this up one. Now, I can show you a little diagram that will help you remember whether you move your exponent up or down. If you move your decimal this way, your exponent's going to go up. If you move your decimal this way, your exponent's going to go down. Now, notice my little arrows here. Here, the arrows go away from each other. Here, they go towards each other. You will never have the arrows going the same direction. They either go towards each other or away from each other. And that's one way you can remember. We moved the decimal this way, so this arrow has to go up, which means I move that decimal up one. And you move it up however many places you moved the decimal. So I moved it one. I'm going to change this to 1.25 times 10 to the positive 6. And that would be your answer. Now, let's say instead of multiplying your scientific notation numbers, you're asked to divide them. We're going to use our exponent rules of subtracting our exponents in order to do that. So let's say that you have 1.2 times 10, which we can use a dot or an x, either one, 10 to the negative 3, and you're dividing that by 2.4 times 10 to the 5th. Now what we're going to do is start with just the numbers and divide these. And 1.2 divided by 2.5 is 0.5 or 0.5. Then with our exponents here on our bases of 10, since we're dividing, we subtract them. So it's going to be negative 3 minus 5. So this is going to be times 10 to the negative 3 minus 5. And you have 0.5 times 10 to the negative 8, because negative 3 minus 5 is negative 8. And again, you're like, wow, I'm done. But notice that this number here is not in scientific notation. We don't have a non-zero digit to the left of our decimal. So we need to move this decimal one place this way to make that happen. So if we move the decimal one place this way, our exponent's going to need to go down. Now be careful when you have negative exponents. Going down and going up will seem opposite of what you intuitively think of. Going down for an 8 is negative 8 minus 1, which is negative 9. It's very common for people to accidentally put negative 7 because 7's smaller than 8. But when you're negative, negative 7 is actually larger than negative 8. So be careful with that common mistake. So we end up with 5 times 10 to the negative 9 for our final answer. And that is everything that you will probably need to know about scientific notation for your homework. And if you have any other questions, feel free to ask.